Mr. Jones, what could you say about this game? We were losing the first 9 innings, and finally we got the victory.
Well, every inning was a challenge. Every pitch was a challenge for both teams. It's good baseball. It's fun to watch. It's always fun to come on the winning side. On our club, we got better today. We competed as a group. I don't know if I had anybody left, and maybe Audrey Perez might have been the only guy that we didn't use. That means everybody grouped together to win this game, and it was fun to watch them celebrate at home plate.
Sobre la pregunta de que nos hable del juego de hoy, sobre todo porque estuvimos perdiendo los primeros 9 episodios, dice que estuvimos batallando en cada entrada, luchando con los desafíos que tuvimos en cada entrada y fuimos mejor equipo hoy, sobre todo porque pudimos conseguir las cosas juntos como equipo y eso nos ayudó a conseguir la victoria. Fue lo más importante, el haber estado juntos, el haber competido como equipo, fue lo que nos dio la victoria a su parecer hoy y es lo que nos va a permitir celebrar esta noche tras el encuentro. Tenemos una pregunta de Enrique Ramírez. Adelante, Enrique.
Good night, Mr. Jones. This was a game of many alternatives. How you stay focused on the team after missing a key at bat in this outing home?
When you enjoy the game of baseball and when you enjoy the group you're with, it's easy to stay focused because guess what? That pitcher, that guy in the batter's box, that catcher, that shortstop that has to hit a fielding ball, that pitcher that has to throw the pitch, throw a breaking ball, the hitter that has to hit the ball, the catcher that has to block that ball, that's a lot harder than a manager just trying to stay focused. I've seen enough games, I got enough experience that I think if I stay out of the way, add a little bit of insight, push a button here or there to allow a guy to use his success, his best tools to have success, it's fun to do. So I don't think there's nothing on me. There's a whole lot on those players and probably those fans watching. I compliment fans for staying and not throwing tomatoes at the TV sometimes when I do something wrong. So thank you.
Sobre la pregunta de cómo se mantuvo enfocado luego de ese out en la goma, dice que es fácil porque quien disfruta el béisbol, pues se mantiene enfocado, sobre todo con un equipo como este, que se mantiene haciendo las cosas que hace el receptor, el pitcher, todos los jugadores, haciendo lo que le corresponde hacer en el equipo, y que además tiene un compromiso con el equipo y con la fanaticada, que dice él que cuando hace cosas malas le siente que le tiran tomates por la televisión, pero que la idea es tratar de estar enfocado y que no es difícil con el equipo que tiene, que le permite disfrutar del juego sobre todo. Tenemos una pregunta de Adam Soriano. Adelante, Adam.
Gracias nuevamente, Michael. Señor Jones, un partido bien interesante. Sin embargo, tengo una pregunta en específico. Luis Liberato no ha estado disponible en estos dos partidos, no ha estado disponible en el line-up específicamente. ¿Qué es lo que pasa con Luis Liberato? ¿Le está dando descanso? ¿Tiene alguna molestia? ¿Qué es lo que realmente está pasando con Luis Liberato? Mr. Jones, a very interesting game that you won today. However, I want to ask about Luis Liberato. What happened with him? He has an injury because he was in the lineup yesterday, and today he wasn't in the lineup too. What is happening with Luis Liberato?
That's a good, really good question. I'm going to just say one thing about it is I didn't win this game. We won this game. Players won this game. Escogido won this game. The fans, I know they're not there in the stadium, but I was at, I probably shouldn't say La Serena because maybe we don't sponsor them, but I was at La Serena today buying something for my wife, and somebody said, oh, Dave Jones, Escogido, and we talked about the game tonight and told them we were going to win, and so it's we, all of us, fans, front office, media, and definitely the players. So But as far as Liberato, he's come up with some tightness in his leg. Our tremendous training staff of Maritza and Achilles and the group in there is making sure that he comes back 100%. He is day-to-day. He was not available today. He actually was going to be available to pinch hit because we had a very similar game last night. And he could have pinched hit, but we would have had to pinch run for him. It's nothing serious. But this game, as I told, I actually told Frankie today after the game that, hey, listen, I'm probably going to think about playing you in the outfield tomorrow again. You know, you're just coming in here and you DH the first time. Now back-to-back games in the outfield. I said, I know you're a young, wonderful athlete, but playing 9 innings or today 10 innings, it's like playing in the States 18 innings. Every game here is double the strain on people, the endurance it takes to play. So that's what I see in Liberato. It's a long way to answer your question, but Liberato will be ready when our training staff, and he says he's ready, and it won't be long, and we have other people that can fill the role that he has. That doesn't mean they can replace him because he's a really good player, but we have players that are really good players right now, and that's who we'll go with, and we'll see when he's ready to go full go, and we'll let you know after I let him know. That's a long one for you to interpret.
Yes, I think I got it.
Okay, you're the best.
Dice que sobre Liberato, que tiene una molestia en la pierna, pero que la idea es tenerlo día a día. Dice que el trabajo que hace el staff de trainings del equipo con Maritza y compañía, pues ha podido mantenerlo saludable. Él es un hombre joven, pero ha preferido detenerlo hasta que esté 100% en condiciones para jugar. Puede ser mañana, puede ser pasado mañana, pero es un asunto de día a día. Y sobre todo, lo toma con precaución porque los partidos aquí son incluso más largos que en Estados Unidos. 9 entradas aquí son como 18 innings de grandes ligas. Y como los partidos son más exigentes, más duraderos, pues prefirió darle ese descanso a Liberato hasta que esté 100% en condiciones para volver a participar con el equipo. Tenemos la pregunta de Melvin Bejarán. Adelante, Melvin.
Dex, mentalmente, ¿qué tanto puede ayudar a Gregory Polanco en lo adelante, el cuadrangular ganador de hoy? Mentally, how much can tonight's winning homer help Gregory Polanco go forward?
Well, Gregory's a really good player. This game either humbles you or you're about to get humbled by it. And that means that nothing's easy. Babe Ruth made an out 7 out of 10 times in his career. That means only 3 times out of 10 times he was successful. A lot of home runs, but still. So you can't take a small sampling. Gregory's a really good player. He's going to continue to be the good player he is day in, day out. That doesn't mean he's going to hit line drives all the time. It doesn't mean he's going to hit 800 because nobody hits 800. Babe Ruth didn't. And maybe he's the greatest player of all time. And so Gregory's working hard. He's a part of the team. And we can talk about Gregory Polanco, but how about Jonathan Nunez? Wrong first name maybe. The reliever in the 9th inning today. Sorry if I called the wrong name. But I had never seen him throw a pitch. And he threw a 9th inning, a shutdown inning that allowed us to come back. So we can talk about Nunez. We can talk about Polanco. This is a team effort. I'm glad Gregory was on this Zoom meeting earlier because he's such a fun, beautiful man and a great player. But I'd just soon talk about Nunez, too, if I remembered his first name. I'm sorry.
It's Andrés Nunez.
Andres. Thank you. Kansas City. I know it's a good sinker and a good slider.
Yes, it is. Dice sobre la pregunta que le hizo Melvin que Gregory es un gran jugador, que no se puede evaluar a Gregory Polanco por la pequeña muestra de turnos que ha tenido hasta el momento, pero que él es un gran jugador y eso lo demostró con este partido de hoy. Y además de que no se puede hablar tampoco de un solo jugador, esta victoria ha sido un esfuerzo de equipo, todo el conjunto ha aportado para esta victoria, pero en el caso de Gregory está completamente seguro de que vendrán mejores momentos para él, esto puede ser un inicio de ello, y puso el caso de que por mejor que seas en el béisbol, si conectas 3 hits de 10 picheos, de 10 oportunidades que tienes para batear, eres un gran jugador, que ni siquiera jugadores como Babe Ruth batearon 800, o sea que hay que darle tiempo para que se ponga en forma y que esto es apenas una muestra de lo que está, de lo que puede suceder con Gregory. Tenemos a Jordaniel Abreu. Adelante, Jordaniel.
Hi, Dave. Some people wonder why so many substitutions in certain games. What will Dave Jones respond to those who question those decisions?
Please keep questioning him, because if you keep questioning him, it's the same way some players will question me doing what I'm doing, because it makes me think on to make sure I'm secure in making the best opportunities for our players to succeed and the best opportunity to use everybody, because we need to use everybody. And guess what? When you aren't scoring runs, you're going to keep moving people around to find the best lineup, to find the best hitter in the spot, and to try to score those runs when they're hard to get to. And this is a league where often they're hard to get to, and when you're stretch that they're really hard to get to, you're going to keep moving until you find those hot hands, and then you go ahead and flow with them. I'd love to have the 1929 Yankees lineup that had Ruth and Gehrig and those guys, and we'd sit back and they'd take me out of the picture, but right now I'm in the picture and we'll see what goes on.
Sobre la pregunta de por qué tantos movimientos durante el partido, en algunos partidos, dice que para ganar y conseguir carreras, conseguir efectos, pues se está probando diferentes lineups, viendo cómo encaja cada jugador dentro de cada posición, pero que la manera es esta, darle oportunidad a todo el mundo en los momentos importantes para que produzcan para el equipo, pero que en general la idea es darle esa oportunidad a todos para que produzcan, para que consigan un buen rol dentro del equipo y va a continuar rotándolo hasta que consigamos ese buen lineup, un lineup que genere resultados, como ya se ha hecho anteriormente. Pero la intención es jugar con todos esos jugadores en momentos importantes. Y David Hernández, adelante.
Dave, buenas noches. Mi pregunta va relacionada, o su valoración, quisiera escuchar su valoración sobre el trabajo de Jumbo Díaz, quien no ha permitido libertades en 8 entradas en la temporada.
What could you say about Jumbo Díaz? He was almost perfect during the season.
He continues to be the pitcher and the man that you expect from what his, what I call it, back of the baseball card says. Because the back of the baseball card said this man is a leader in the dugout, in the clubhouse, and on the field to say, hey, jump on my back. And I've got some history with him. I remember being with him in 2007, maybe 6. 2006 in L.A. and Vero Beach in spring training, and got to meet the young Jumbo Díaz. And he has grown, but he was a really fun man to be with then. And he had a lot of potential, and he continues to do what he does, and kept us in the game, and didn't do what he usually does, because he usually get saves and holds. Today he got a W. It's great seeing a W. And by the way, Jonathan Nunez did pitch for me in 2009 for Licea, Jonathan Nunez. So I'm sorry, my mind went back to 2009, and he was an 8th inning sinker ball guy, just like Andrés Nunez right now. I hope Andrés Nunez becomes as good as Jonathan Nunez, and he has a chance. Sorry for that digression.
Lo último que dice es que tuvo un pitcher llamado Jonathan Núñez en 2009 y que por eso el error con Andrés Núñez, pero que por eso fue la confusión. Jonathan Núñez es aquel y este es Andrés Núñez. Sobre Jumbo Díaz, dice que es el hombre con el que cuenta para cubrirle las espaldas en el octavo, al final del partido prácticamente, y que lo conoce desde hace mucho tiempo, desde 2006 en Estados Unidos, lo vio y sabía el potencial que tenía, ya ha crecido, conocía de este potencial que tenía, y de hecho es lo que está viendo en esta liga. Y es el jugador dentro del dugout, que es el líder dentro del clubhouse, al que todos respetan, con el que todos comparten, es como la especie del alma de todo el dugout, y lo respeta bastante por eso, y por supuesto esas actuaciones que ha tenido, pues también son formidables. Concluimos con Melvin Bejarán.
Jaus, ¿qué nos puede decir del relevo de Rainer Cruz en el quinto inning? What can you say about the work of Rainer Cruz during the fifth inning?
Rainer again is that experienced guy that, you know, I go back to knowing people from far, from a long time ago. I remember Rainer Cruz from 2011 when he was a young minor league player trying to learn his craft, and had always had a really good arm and hadn't found the command and the composure on the mound. And now he's that veteran guy that has command and composure, and we bring him in, I'm comfortable. Our players are comfortable. The dugout's comfortable because we know we're going to get everything he has with some purpose behind it and some competitive nature that knows you got a chance to win. And that's what he did again tonight in a tough situation. Kept that game close. And it's a really good question, because it's easy to see, and I love Gregory Polanco. It's easy to see Gregory Polanco's home run. It's easy to see Lopez driving a run with two outs in the ninth. But to see those parts of the detail of the game where Rainer does a good job, both Guzman and Rosa at shortstop, Valerio comes in and catches Humbo in the 10th inning. Humbo maybe shouldn't get the win. Maybe give it to Valerio, the backup catcher who comes in. And, you know, I know you can't do that, but I told Valerio that he got the win tonight because he caught Humbo. So I like the question, and it was great seeing Rainer do what he needed to do.
Dice que en el caso de Cruz, pues vio una, bueno, ya lo conocía desde hace ya unos años en Grandes Ligas en Estados Unidos, y que es muy fácil ver el batazo que dio Otto López, el batazo que dio Gregory Polanco para empatar y ganar el juego respectivamente, pero que fijarse en los detalles de Cruz lanzando en el quinto, consiguiendo los outs que consiguió, son detalles que muchas veces se pierden, pero que son importantes dentro del juego, y que sobre todo él es un lanzador que, como conocía desde hace mucho tiempo, le veía siempre esa compostura, ese conocimiento, esa tranquilidad cuando sube a lanzar, y ahora, como ya un hombre crecido, ya con más experiencia en el béisbol, pues se siente todavía más cómodo con él, más confortable, y lo mismo sucede en el dugout, en el clubhouse, con los jugadores que se sienten bastante cómodos con él. Thank you very much, Mr. Jaws, for your time again. It was a pleasure. Gracias a todos ustedes por haber estado con nosotros. Pasen buenas noches y hasta un próximo encuentro con los Leones del Escogido.